My name is Raja. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create a simple HTML page. So I'm going to be creating a simple folder first and call it my first web page. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to open up the text editor called Sublime Text. So you can use your favorite text editor, but I'll be using Sublime Text in this video. So it's going to look like that. So I'm going to first save that before writing any HTML code inside. I'm going to click File and Save. I'm just saving that file inside the folder I created. I'm going to just navigate to that folder, my first web page, and I'm going to call it index.html. So index is the primary. So if you have lots of HTML pages inside this folder, when you are trying to access the website, it's going to look for index first. So if you have index.html, this is going to be the your front face of that website. So make sure that it has to be index.html. So we successfully created our first HTML page. So I want to view this page in the browser. The simple way to do that, you just open up your folder and you can double click or you can right click to open with any browser you have. Right now, I'm going to open up with Google Chrome. So it looks like that. I'm going to resize it so that you can see both screen in here. So right now, currently in that page is empty because I don't have anything there. So I'm going to be adding some like a content, like a HTML elements. So as I just writing, you can see the changes in the browser. So first thing I want to any web page, you have to declare the doc type. So doc type is it's telling the browser how to render that web page in which version of HTML, because HTML has lots of versions because it's evolving over the years. So right currently HTML5 is famous. So before people used to use like HTML4, and lots of website currently running in HTML4 XHTML like that. So in this video we'll be focusing only the HTML5. We're just telling the browser like we want this web page to render in HTML5. So that is all this doc type means. So what I'm doing, I'm just trying to put the angle bracket and exclamation mark and just type the doc type and space HTML and closing angle bracket. That's it. So that's all we have to tell the browser. I want this page to be rendered as HTML5 in the browser. That's all it means. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to be saving because I have the habit of saving. So you can see as I'm writing a single line of every line of code, I just hit Control S to make sure that I save that file. So the next one is this is called like tag because it's starting with angle bracket and angle bracket, but it doesn't have normally HTML tags have starting and ending tags. So for example, like HTML, this is how you write the starting HTML tag, which is it could be we have some HTML tag. HTML is one of the HTML tags. This is how you write that starting angle bracket and ending angle bracket. So the closing tag for that, all you have to do is to add the slash in front of that text. So now you have this tag, starting tag and ending tag of the element. So every page has to have that because whatever we put inside that, that's going to be considered HTML, part of HTML page. So make sure that all of them, all the content you write should be inside between those. So, you know, this has to be the last line pretty much. So one more thing I want to point out, why would you need this? Because we are going to, like if you think about that, if you are writing a resume, so all you have to do, you need to format, right? You just don't write all of them. Like you just put the heading first, different size, and subheadings and bullet points, so that the person who is reading the resume, it's easy to understand. So the same way, what we are going to do, we are doing this. We don't have that, like what we have in Microsoft Word, select the text bold, italic, and different font size. We do the same thing, but in code way. So that's all why we need to do all the tags. It's not only good for human reading, and also it's good for the Google, like the machine reading. For example, Google trying to find what is the heading for this page. If you tell them like, okay, I want this to be the heading for this page, so Google can easily identify that. So that's why we want to structure all of our data in the page using HTML tags. So we have HTML element here. The difference between HTML tag and element, if you have just one, it's called HTML tag. If you have a starting and ending tag together, that's called HTML element. Okay, so I'm going to be adding, it's kind of nesting. You're adding inside, adding like a parent, children, grandchildren, and so on. So it's like a tree structure. If you have already have a programming experience before, like you know how the JSON work, nodes inside the nodes inside nodes, like pretty much like arrays like that. So array of object inside array of object like that. So we have that HTML element. We are going to add two more elements inside that which are more important. One is head tag. So again, if you look at that HTML, like you have the starting tag and ending tag with slash. So this is a head. So what we put in here, it's invisible to the user. So you don't see in this white area, but behind the scene, it helps you to add some kind of metadata. Like if you have the external files, a JavaScript or something like that, you can add there too. And you know, like, so those are the main purpose. Like if you want any functionality, that's really good for like a SEO purposes, like a search engine optimization. There are lots of things you can do with inside head, but that is invisible to the user in the screen. So anything we want to put to be visible, we want to put inside another tag. It's called body tag. So this is the starting tag of the body. This is ending tag. Okay. So everything the user sees should be inside this element. Okay, so for example, if I save it and if I refresh this page, you can see that. Because if I copy and paste in here, you still see that because of you do not wrap with any other tags or elements. So the one of the main tags you have to use for every page is title. So title has starting tag, ending tag like others, so I'm going to be just putting that starting tag. Every time you put text, it has to be inside these two tags, starting and ending tags. So if I save that, so the title means like in here what you see in the top of that the browser, that's what you put in here. If you refresh it, you can see here, right? So I'm going to change that into my web page. This pretty much describes what the page is all about. Okay, so our primary focus from now onwards most likely to be inside this section, inside this body element. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to be adding some tags in here. Okay, so I'm going to be showing like how to create some more HTML elements here. So the H1, it's for example like H1 is the one of the tags. It's going to be like heading one, it's called. For example, if you are writing a resume, this could be the text resume, and H2 could be like the second level heading, like the qualification, like that. You see the difference? Like most of the HTML tags have their own style. For example, if it has a big font and the dark color, you know, like specific font family, but we can use with CSS that we will talk about later. So I'm going to be adding some few more here. So you can go up to H1, H2, up to H6. So you can do the H1, H2, H3, H6. For example, like you can say something like copyright. If you have the smaller text like that. So that's the different like a six sizes of heading. So what we want to do with the paragraph inside that here, for example, I can use the paragraph P tag, that's called paragraph starting and ending tags. So I'm going to just grab some dummy text. So I'm going to copy and paste it in here. Now you can see that this whole paragraph text inside starting tag and ending tag. So I'm going to save that. I'm going to refresh it in here so you can see that paragraph. It's nice, nicely. It has its own format style. But whatever we put in here, we can change in CSS. We have full control how we want it to look. Okay, so I'm going to be starting with the next one is I'm going to be adding some image. That's how do I add image to the web page. There are some tags. I'm going to be just putting that another H2 maybe. Some tags do not have ending tag. Ending tag, they are called self-closing tags. So I'm going to be showing one. It's a H3 image tag is one of them. So I'm going to show you how to use the image tag here. So you start with img, right? So if it is a self-closing tag, if you have the ending tag, we use it like this, but there are some exception for some HTML tags that do not have ending tag. Instead, we just use the slash inside the starting tag, indicating that this is the self-closing HTML tag. Okay, so I have an image here, but how do I add the, because this one is showing here, but this tag doesn't show because there is no content here. Because if you have this, we can add something there, like for example, like if you have image somewhere, you can just do the URL link, right? So it's not working like that. What we have to do in here, there is a new concept called attribute. Is like you can add attribute to any HTML tag, HTML starting tag. So normally you add attributes in the starting tag, not ending tag. So there are two ways to add attributes, are two types to add attributes. One is custom and predefined. Okay, so in here HTML comes with, like, image tag comes with a predefined image tag has predefined attributes. Okay, how to create an attribute? It's very simple. You just attribute name, you just type the attribute name equals, and double quotes, you have a value. For example, like you have name here, I'm going to put my name Raja. That's the like attribute name and value. So I, as I mentioned earlier, that image tag has its own attribute, predefined one, which is called href and equal sign double quotes. What we have to put inside that, the image location. For example, if you have right now I have a few images I can use. I'm going to be or I can use any image from the browser. I'm going to just go type like a fruits image, or maybe soft author. Maybe I want the logo. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to be moving to images, click that logo and click back again. Hopefully it takes me to, oh, it's not, maybe this page. Okay, I'm going to just grab that, I'm going to drag and drop the image in here. Okay, we have image, that image name. So after, I'm going to copy that image name there. So the way, you just click once. So you select all, double click to select all, and command C to copy. And what I'm going to do, there are a few ways to do this, because I have that another, I have the folder and the HTML file inside here, right? So what I'm going to put, I'm going to put that image inside in here, so that because of it is the same level, so I can just use the soft author, the logo name inside this href here, like that. So I'm going to copy that, paste it there, and save it or refresh it. Okay, that's interesting why it's not showing the oh, okay. Okay, image tag has its own predefined attribute. It's called src source. So in that case, I'm going to be adding that. So save it, refresh it. Now you can see that. Okay, cool. So it's a source src. So this is how you add images inside your web page. Okay, so we can move on to the next one. I want to show you the other one like this that has another tag, anchor tag. Anchor tag. I'm going to just put like a another, this is also self-closing tag like image. So what it does is just put the horizontal rule underneath this so that, you know, like this kind of heading, this h3, and we just add that underline there. There are different ways to do this in CSS, but in HTML you just use this. So okay, how do I create anchor tag? Why I need to use anchor tag? For example, if you want to click any button to take it to the other page, so that's where the anchor tag comes. The way you create anchor tag, like A, and it has starting and ending tag like that, right? Like others, like h3. But this attribute, as I mentioned earlier, this attribute can be added to any tag. It doesn't matter whether it's a self-closing tag like this or it has starting and end tag. Okay, so I'm going to be adding some link here. For example, I want to go to the soft author website. So I'm just putting in a soft author. So what you can see here, we have the text what I typed in here, but it's not clickable or it doesn't go anywhere. So we need to add the path. For example, every time when I click this text, I want to go to the soft author page. So I'm going to copy the URL. That's where I want to go. Most of all the time you have to go to the address bar in the browser if you want to your link to go to some specific page. You go open up that page on the browser, just click on address bar and command A to select all and copy it and come back. And you need to use there is another predefined attribute for anchor tag that will take care of it, which is called href. So this attribute name equals double quotes, we just add the value inside that, in this case the URL. So I'm going to be adding, copy and paste that URL. You notice that like we don't see the http://. So in here, you know, when you copy it, it comes with that. You know, it's better to, rather than typing in here, it's just better to copy and paste it here. That's the way we can make sure that it's going to work. So now I'm saving that file and go to the page and refresh. Now you have the underline and the text color turns into a little bit like a purpley blue. This is the default style for anchor tag. Again, we can change whatever we want using CSS, but we just use HTML for now. So if I close it, so I'm going to be clicking this. So guess what? It's going to go to the soft author page. It's loading and it's going there. And where is my page now? Because what happened when you click that page, it's just reloading the same page to that page, right? So you don't see that page you are in before. You need to go back. So when I click that, it just changed the page into that page and back. Okay, so you could add another attribute to mention that to go to the separate page, open up the separate page, not just keep this page up. Yeah, you can do the another attribute the same way. Like, you can add more than one attribute to any tag. So I'm going to be adding another tag. It's called target. What it means, like, it means I want this to open up the separate new window. So I'm going to just say that. Yeah, it looks a little bit awkward, but this is how you do it. Underscore blank. This is a value. This is it's a predefined value, predefined attribute name. In here, predefined attribute name, the value could be anything, but here it's a predefined attribute name and predefined value. It has a 4 or 5 values, and just use that default one for opening the new window when you click any anchor link. So I'm going to refresh that page now and click soft author. So now, as you can see, it opens up a new page, but my old page where I initialized that click, it stays there. So that's pretty cool. Okay, so now we got the anchor tag working. This anchor tag is very important. It's being used all over the place. For example, if you go to the soft author, you see the link here. This is all of them are anchor tag. When you click in every one, it's going to go to this specific page, right? Every time when you see the navigation in the website, most of the time it's being used using anchor tag with some other HTML tags too, but predominantly this tag just taking make sure that going to that specific link. Okay, okay, we have another concept. That concept called, I'm going to make it H2. Inline versus block. So now you can see a little bit. I'm going to be adding that same, so it looks like okay. So inline versus block, because some of the, if you look at that, some of them are something like, if you look at that, like some of them takes over the whole entire width of the screen, right? Some of them might not, so that's called inline and block. For example, like I want this to be the image, the text should be beside that, not like under that. So that's called inline. If you use the inline tags, you can achieve that. So I'm going to be showing that inline tags. So there are a few inline tags you can use. We already used one. I think the anchor tags, and if I just copy and place another anchor tag there, so what happened here is not going to be under that, it's going to be beside that, because because that is anchor tag is, it's an inline HTML element, similar to image img tag, like this here. For example, if I could add more to that, because I add, for example, image, I mentioned that, which is source, and I could add width and height like this, so I can specify that I want this to be, normally we just, you just use the proper width and height here. So how do I find the proper width and height for the image? If you go to the image, select the image, you can see the dimension. This is the width, this is the height. So this image is 500 pixel width wide and 88 pixel height. So I can use 500 and height 88, right? So this is not going to change anything, because we just use the exact same thing. For sake of this purposes, I want to see, I want to show you like image tag, it's the inline. So I'm going to reduce that into 200. I'm going to get rid of height, because I don't know what is the proportion for that. So like that, if you look at that, it just going to that previous text, right? It's running to the previous text. So because if you look at that, this text doesn't have any markup surrounded by that, right? It's kind of, because we have h3, that's done, we start another tag, every single text has to have its own tag, otherwise it's not going to be good. So I'm going to wrap it with paragraph tag, and paragraph starting and paragraph ending tag here. So now what's happening, the paragraph tag is block level element, which means like it needs its own space, it's not letting anyone to come in here like that. So whereas image tag and anchor tags are inline tags, so if you copy another image there, it's going to go beside in here because of its inline HTML tag. So I can have multiple like that, so it's going to be keep adding like that one by one, right? So that is the, like if you look at the other ones like h1, like a block level tags, h1 h2 h3 h4 h5 and h6 paragraph. And I'm just trying to pick based on what I have used so far. So these are the block level tags, because they don't allow any another element to go beside them. They always push down. That is the default. So this H1, this is block level. It needs a full, which means like I can show you that. Don't worry about that. This tool here, but I want to show you that this is the h1, it takes the full, but because we put h1 resume, right? Resume, you may think like, okay, h1 tag, it just starts, ends in here, right? Not, there's an invisible box there, so it takes the whole width. That's why whenever you add anything here next to that, it just push down, because h1 is the block level element. So if you want to know more tags, more elements, you just go to W3 school and here learn HTML. Go to the HTML tag list. These are the tags, pretty important tags here. If you have any, if you want any reference, if you do not know any what tag does what, you can go and take the reference there. Oh, I forgot to say one more tag in here, which is commonly used one. There's also a block level element called div. The way you create that div, it's similar to other tags you use, like starting div and ending div tag. So you can put any text inside that. This is, and you can just see that this is div. This is also like a block level element. Okay, hope you understand today that what is how to create a simple web page, and how what is the difference between the head section and the body section. So what you can put in there, it's invisible, it's for metadata, it's for SEO purposes, and what the user see should go inside the body starting and ending body tag. Right, so we are adding, we just learn a few HTML tags like h1, h2, p, and we just know like how to create element, what is the difference between element HTML like tags versus element, and same like h1 to h6 you have a different sizes for that, and you learn how to create a paragraph tag, and you know what's the difference, how to create attribute, and we have two types of attribute, custom and predefined. We just see all the, we saw predefined ones. For example, if you, when you want to add an image, you have the predefined attribute called source, and you have another predefined width attribute name. And if you go back to anchor one, there's another anchor tag, is very useful. It's being used all over the place in the website, mostly in the navigation section. So, you know, like when you want your website to go somewhere by clicking some button, so you just use this one. And now after that, you learn like what's different between inline and block. So inline tags, they don't occupy the whole width of the browser, they occupy only their own space, whereas block level HTML elements, they want the whole space, even though their text is small, like what we saw in resume, it needs the whole width there. And also we use the div. Div is pretty common to use whenever you want to, you're not sure what to use pretty much, but after the HTML5 tags, it's going to be used less. So I will show you the HTML5 tags in the next video. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you.